Hi, I am Holland coming to you from Hawaii, and today we are going to be talking about, could food be the link to your disease? So I am so excited to be talking to you about this today. I am coming to you from my home in Hawaii and wanted to bring a little of the outside in. I wish I was in a stage in front of you and able to meet with all of you, but I am so happy to be here. So let's just get right to it. My name is Holland, and I was raised on a standard American diet. Actually, maybe even more of an unhealthy standard American diet. I didn't even know until I was 22 that people drank water to stay hydrated. In my fridge, we had soda, orange juice, milk, chocolate milk, and I even was allowed to put sugar on my Frosted Flakes. So there weren't really any rules or boundaries on food in my house. And when I look back, I see I actually had quite a bit of illness as a child. They didn't call it autoimmune then, but it definitely was autoimmune disorders where they couldn't figure out why my body had turned on me. And I just was sick and missed school all the time. And then when I started menstruating, once a month I would be taken out of life for about a week, throwing up, the worst cramps ever, and just felt like my body was once again turning on me. I didn't even know what health could feel like. And then I had kids. I had them pretty young. At 22, I had my first, my second at 25, and my third at 29. At that point, I had no health. I had no vitality for life. I was overweight. I had had surgery for endometriosis twice. I had had kidney stones and so many other symptoms that went along with just being out of health. And so I decided at one point that I was too young to feel the way I felt. I didn't know what it was, but I knew there was something that I could do to support myself and try to find it. And so I started doing research, and I read a book about being vegan that really changed my life. There were so many ahas about disease and food, and I started thinking about food as energy and nourishment, as opposed to something that just tasted yummy and made me feel not hungry. And so I decided I wanted to try it out. And so I went vegetarian for one day and then made the switch to vegan the next day. And it's been 14 years since then. And I want to tell you what I've learned along the way. So right away when I went vegan, I started noticing that my symptoms were disappearing. I was losing weight in a healthy manner. I felt good. I had more of a vibrancy for life. I wanted to go on walks. I felt happy. And I just noticed all of these subtle changes over time. Like, oh my God, I don't have leg cramps anymore. And so for me, when I went vegan, it gave me health. And I didn't ever want to look back. I didn't want to figure out if it was one ingredient that had caused this in me that I had just figured out. But all I knew is I felt good and I wasn't gonna mess with anything but that. And I also was lucky because I had gone to culinary school and had a background in food. 14 years ago, there were not vegan restaurants, there were not vegan options, or at least not a lot of them like there are today. And so when I made the switch, instead of feeling deprived, all of a sudden, there were all these ingredients I didn't even know about. I mean, plants I had never seen, you know, besides eggplant parmesan, I didn't know what to do with an eggplant, and that there was romesco and cauliflower and broccoli, and if they were going to be the stars of the dish, what did that look like? And so I went into the kitchen, and I definitely had all of my favorite foods at the same time as finding my health. I hadn't lost my love of food. I actually had gained it, and I was gaining health. And then I started wondering, like, why isn't everybody doing this, right? Like, if I feel so good, shouldn't it be everyone? And so it became my mission to change everyone to vegan, right? Like, this changed my life. And so I spent about 5 or 6 years really starting to understand nutrition, understand what was out there, and what was out there in terms of vegan and in terms of just nutrition, and really what is my health. And so what I started to realize is that health is an evolution, and every body is different. Everybody is either low in something or too high in something. And so, you know, we're like these science experiments looking for the perfect formula, and there is not one size fits all. My size fit me, and so I kind of switched to wanting to teach people how to find their health and how to get started on their health evolution. And so 14 years later, I want to let you know that I have cured my endometriosis. I do not have kidney stones. I have lost and kept off the weight. And I also, the biggest gift of all of this, I feel like I own my health. I know if I do go down or if something happens, that there's foods and different vitamins and supplements that can support me in getting better. And owning your own health is ultimate freedom in your body. And so how can I teach people this? And so what I want to ask is, are you willing to break up with your current beliefs? Are you willing to look at where your beliefs came from? I want to remind you that we inherit most of our habits from our families. We also inherit most of our disease from our families. And possibly it could be genetic, but possibly it could be that heart disease runs in your family because of the foods your family eat. And are you willing to think about that? Are you willing to think that lifestyle may cause disease that runs in families? And if so, are you willing to be the change in your life and in your family to figure that out? Because that was huge for me. Things that run in my family do not run in me, and I hope that they will not run in my children as they adopt more of my healthy habits. And so, are you willing to look at why you think you need meat all the time? Are you willing to look at why you think, trying to think of some of the things clients say to me, why you think fruit is bad for you, why you think carbs are bad for you, why you think you need so much protein? Because most people who come to me who are looking for health and don't have it definitely have a lot of beliefs and a lot of righteousness about those beliefs. And to make any change, you have to do things different. And so I believe any diet works. Any diet. Keto, paleo, the all-meat diet, Atkins, raw. And the reason it works is because it makes us consciously look at what we're eating. It also makes us make changes which support our body for that moment. And we start to have changes in our body because our body wants to heal. But a lot of those diets aren't sustainable, aren't manageable, and they're not practical. And also, if you think about yourself being an evolving being who ages and whose cells change, your needs are going to change. So there is not one diet you can stick to for the rest of your life. Like, I'm vegan, right? I will probably be vegan for the rest of my life. There are 20 different resets, 20 different types of ways I eat, and I'm constantly thinking of myself as a science experiment and seeing what's working for me at that particular time in my life. And so I just ask you, are you willing to break up with your beliefs? I also want to point out that not really one doctor asked me to look at what I was eating when I was a kid or as an adult. In fact, a lot of doctors want to argue with me that I shouldn't be in good health with the way I eat. And I know that not to be true. I really believe that plants are the healers of our body. And I'm not saying you have to eat like me and go all vegan. I'm just saying you definitely want to add more plants, fruits, and veggies into your life. I believe it's the missing key to health for so many people. And also, health doesn't mean that you're losing your love of food. My vegan lasagna makes me just as happy as my vegetarian or my meat lasagna did. I want to teach you ways to replace products so that you know how to make your grandma's lasagna recipe as close as possible, but having it be healthy. I also want to say, I don't think a vegan diet is a one-size-fits-all, you're going to have a great life and no problems. But I do believe getting in touch with your body, consciously eating more like our natural world, which naturally is so much more plentiful in fruits and vegetables than animals and eggs or milk. So right there, if we look at the natural world, you'll see there are thousands of mangoes on trees, bananas that grow all the time. And, you know, I think it's important to have periods of rest. Everything is seasonal. But you do really want to think of it like a multivitamin of what you're eating. So for me, I love starting the day with simple things. So I used to eat cereal in the morning, toast, but what I found works for my body is a combination of nuts and fruits. I know that doesn't sound fun, but I do that through a smoothie, which I absolutely love. I'll give you an example of one right now. So I would start with almond butter, almond milk, frozen strawberries, a few dates, and then I would go ahead and blend that up and just enjoy it. I know that I have the most energy when I'm eating that way. If my smoothies stop giving me energy, I'm gonna switch to possibly a gluten-free bread or sourdough bread avocado toast and see how that supports my body. So I constantly am listening and checking in with myself. I think this is the best way to avoid having your doctor holding the keys for you. I am not against Western medicine, but I do believe we haven't been taught how powerful our bodies are and that food, which is the main thing we put into our bodies, is a huge contributor to your health. So my name is Holland. I am so happy to be here with you and talk about these things. I do have a cookbook and recipes online if you're interested in learning more about replacing items or you think that possibly food could be the reason you're in disease, which I remind you all, in disease just means out of ease and your body wants to be in ease. So I hope we can stay in touch. I hope to hear from all of you. It is so, so lovely to be able to be in front of you at your homes. Number one, I want you to have a why. Why is it you want to eat this way? What is it you want to change about your life to create a new lifestyle? A lot of times our why becomes our North Star or our compass on why we're doing something, and it allows us to follow it. So get clear on your why. Whether you create a mental list, you go pen to paper, I just want you to know why you're doing this. Number two, educate yourself on the meat and dairy industry. It really only takes one Google search or one YouTube video for you to understand why you're making this change. Number three, baby steps. I want you to walk into this in baby steps. What is it I can change or do today? Maybe it's ordering that latte with almond milk. Maybe it's meeting a friend at a vegan restaurant. But start to take baby steps so that you can fully bring yourself into this lifestyle without it seeming overwhelming. Number four, I want you to overeat. A lot of people tell me that they don't feel full off vegan foods. And what I want to tell you is in the beginning, it takes a while for your body and appetite to catch up. So go ahead and overeat. Have more salad. Have a second helping. Drink a second smoothie. Do whatever it is you need to do to feel satiated, and you're going to be more likely to stick to it. Number 5, I want you to concentrate on nutrient-based whole foods. I want you to be able to eat things in their purest form. We all know whole foods are better than processed foods, so I want to make sure you understand eating this way literally means eating your vitamins and minerals. So you want to make sure to get variety of nutrient-based foods. Number 6, replace it. I don't want you to give up everything. I want to make sure you understand that there's probably a vegan replacement to the ingredient you love. And as you start learning those, you're going to be able to recreate recipes that you love and get a stick to. Number 7 is go ahead and search and learn about vegan restaurants. There's so many out there and they do incredible things with food. This is where I get so many of my ideas. On top of it, those restaurants you love, start to learn and see what they offer for vegan foods. You may fall in love with something you didn't even know existed. I'm also going to include my eating out guide below, just so you have an idea of what you can order at maybe restaurants you already go to. 8, let's talk about water. You're going to be eating more fiber than you ever have, so it's so important that you hydrate yourself. Water is maybe the most cleansing ingredient we have on this planet, so just go ahead and make sure that you are using it. Number 9, eat more organic. If you're doing this for it to be better for you, for animals, or the planet, eating organic is incredible. It's supporting people that have practices that are more natural and more with nature. You'll also feel a huge difference in your body. Number 10 is to be easy on yourself. Everyone has slips. Everyone makes the wrong mistakes. It's not about if you've fallen. It's about if you get up. So I just want to support you in being easy on yourself, not beating yourself up, and making sure you just keep coming back to that why. I hope that this gave you some insight and some tricks and tools that are going to make going vegan easier for you.
Making summer rolls, one of my favorite salads.
I start with my rice paper and dip it in cold water. Give it a little shake off and just put it right on the surface you're gonna roll on. We're gonna put carrots right down the middle along with some fresh chopped herbs. I have a little napa cabbage, red cabbage, and mung bean noodles already done, organic greens. I just go ahead, fold it over, pull everything in so it's nice and tight, and go ahead and roll. And same on the other. I'm just gonna cut them right down the middle. Here at the cafe, we actually serve them with our house-made peanut sauce dressing. And we use organic sriracha to give it a little kick. On the list. This is one of my favorite meals even before I went vegan, and in all honesty, I love this simple recipe so much that I never miss French toast. And so normally French toast is going to be eggs and milk mixed together that we dip our bread in. For our vegan version, we're actually just going to make a slurry, like a crust, little dipping, and we're going to use flour. I have regular all-purpose flour here. I'm going to say I'm putting in about a cup. And then I'm going to take a whisk and go ahead and add a non-dairy milk. I'm using coconut milk today. You can use almond milk, cashew, oat. But you just want to make sure that it's dippable. So we're going to add just a little more in there. And then I love the sweetness of maple syrup, and I add just a little bit. I'm going to say I put in about a tablespoon there. And so, instead of an egg mixture, we have our flour, French toast, vegan dipping sauce. And so I'm going to go ahead and add a little vegan butter to the pan. I always think it tastes yummier if it's cooked in butter. And we're going to go ahead and take our French bread. You can either do store-bought or go ahead and have your own. And you just do a light dipping on both sides. And I kind of move the butter around when I put it down. And you're just going to repeat it on both sides. This is maybe one of my kids' favorite recipes for sure as well. Last one that will fit in our pan. And I am very, very fond of cinnamon. And so instead of putting it in the batter, I enjoy sprinkling a little over the top. And you can put as much as you like. Like I said, I'm pretty fond. And we're gonna let these sizzle. I have it on about a medium heat right now. I may lower it, because we want to make sure that it doesn't overcook or get black. We want a really beautiful light golden crust on this. So we'll see you in a minute when we're flipping. So we're just going to go ahead. It's been a couple minutes, and we're going to go ahead and flip over our French toast. It's looking perfect. If it sticks, sometimes you just want to add a little more butter to the pan so it loosens up a little. And here comes the final. Gonna let it cook for about 2 or 3 minutes. If you love cinnamon, as I do, you can sprinkle a little extra over the top. So our French toast is done, and it's looking beautiful. I'm gonna bring it over here to plate it. And then fan of Earth Balance Vegan Butter. I get the soy-free. It is so delicious. And I think it's so important with all of your meals to do the things that you loved before. If you loved French toast and you loved having it with butter and maple syrup, then just do that in a vegan form. You'll be amazed at how much better you feel when you have quality ingredients that bring you energy as opposed to taking it away. And I have 100% grade A maple syrup here. Just gonna do that right over the top. For me, like I said, I love cinnamon. And I'm just gonna sprinkle a little over the plate so I have extra. And then, make sure I always have some live foods on there. We're gonna do blueberries today. And voila! This is my vegan French toast. Oui, oui.